Guys, I'm coming to you with it. I don't think it's going to be a quick project. I hope it is, but you may or may not know, I out in the back of the, behind the office, I put a deck connecting the back part of the office to the rest of the facility, and I want to open a kind of a showroom, brick and mortar there for some of my larger items, my furniture and things like that. Well, that deck's kind of nice. There's a breeze back there, and I hang out there sometimes, but the problem is when I'm out there, I don't know who's coming in and walking around the shop or coming up to the shop. So I want some way to notify them. So I've been wanting to make a dinger or something like that. So today I'm sitting around and I'm looking and I see this CO2 argon tank. And I just figure, all right, I'll just cut the bottom off of it and let them pound on it and turn it into, you know, some type of a gong type thing. But as I was looking at it, the shape here, the round shape at the top, I'm thinking I could flare that out and actually turn this thing into something that looks like a bell. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to give it a try. It's certainly not a priority project, but I want some way to be notified if I'm in the office or I'm out back, that somebody's here. So we're going to go ahead and turn this tank into a bell, or we're going to try to. So stay tuned. All right, I'm going to give myself a line here around the bottom. Nothing high tech, just holding a Sharpie at the same elevation off of my table. I'm not sure if I'm going to cut this with the plasma or cut it with the grinder. I think I'm going to go with the grinder, though it might take a heck of a lot longer. But I don't know how thick this tank is. It sure does feel like a heavy tank. I'm not sure if that plasma cutter will do a good job through there or not. But there's our line. That's what we'll make the bottom of the bell, and then we'll see if we can flare that thing out. So let me think about how I'm going to start this. Like I said, I'm going to start off with the angle grinder, at least to put a score on for the line. If it seems to cut okay with that, I'll just keep going. So when I come back, you'll probably see a cut tank. Hey, hoody, cut hard. I didn't even use a full disc. That's how I judge my cuts now. Of course, I use one of my heavier wheels, but still. Ouch, a little warm. It's a quarter inch thick anyway. I bet you're pretty close to it. So this would have it. See, and that's it. That's all I was going to do. I was just going to hang this thing up like this, give them a little knocker, and I was going to be done with it. But we can do more, right? We can turn this thing into a bell, right? Don't you think we can flare that out? I think it's good enough like that. Video's over. Nice talking to you. All right, let me figure out how to rig myself a handle on this thing so I can work with it, and we're gonna go all the way with it. What the hell? When I get done, I wanna be able to have this thing look like the top of a propane tank. So I didn't really want to put a huge amount of weld up there. So I put a washer on, piece of rebar, and then tack that on. Hopefully that's enough, and I'm gonna be able to grind those tacks off and not lose that top. Because I might want people to recognize that top as an air tank or a propane gas tank, whatever the hell they think of it is. So the idea is, I think, I'm not sure which way I'm going to go with it, but I think I can work this over the horn. Now, again, I don't know what the frick I'm doing. You think you'd just be able to flare it out and be done with it. Maybe I can do it that easily. If not, by stretching the steel on the outside, it'll increase the diameter, and that's going to force it to curl. So if I can't just flare it easily once it's hot, then you might have to just try what the frick's the word I'm looking for? Anyway, stretch that steel out with a cross beam and flare it. So that's the plan. Let me get this thing heated up. Couple things about safety, guys. Number one, don't go cutting open some freaking tank you don't know anything about, for crying out loud. This came from the scrapyard. The top was off. It was totally open to the air. Definitely nothing, you know, nothing. There was no chamber there for this thing to explode. Also, it didn't contain propane or anything flammable at any time. I have no idea whether the carbon dioxide argon could have seeped into the walls and caused some type of thing to breathe. So wear a mask, especially. Make sure you're not cutting open a silly tank that you don't know anything about. Make sure the tank is already open someplace. All right, don't be stupid and die. That's not a good thing to do. All right, let's heat this thing up. Thing about safety with this is that there is still, even though that tank's pretty rusty, there is still a little residual paint on the outside. So I got the fans on. going to heat this thing up, burn a lot of that stuff off before I get involved with too much, just to make sure I'm not breathing that. So again, safety, somewhere in the top three, would you? Deal with those fans for a little while. This is one of those projects where it's going to be one of those things where I wish I could heat the whole freaking bottom. And I can probably do that, but by the time I do, I'm going to spend a whole lot of time on it. So I'm going to accept that I can't. We're going to take a little bit at a time. Oops, I just dropped a lot of coal on the floor. We're okay. Everybody's good. A little bit of time, and I'm just going to go ahead and start pulling this thing out a little. I lost all my heat. We'll go back and do it. But we'll work to start flaring that out. I think it's going to work. You can already see that. I can see it. Why can't you see it? Right here. So go back in. We're going to take our time on this one. It's going to take a while, heat by heat, for sure. Changed my mind. I got the round of the anvil doing the fullering for me, so I don't need to mess with that. I'm just going to stretch that out a little. Can't work much at all. We can work a little bit of it, though, and we'll go on to the next spot. We'll get the next section going here. Until we get an idea of what this steel is doing. See it happening, right? Step by step, little by little. Go get it. I think we should have just left her the way she was. It wasn't that bad. I'm tempted to turn this anvil over. It'd be a little better. The top of that horn wasn't round or flat. If it was curved up a little more, I think it would actually be better for me. We are learning anyway. We'll figure this out at some point in time. I think I can work over the horn on the inside with a smaller hammer and try to get up in here a little deeper, but you see what we're doing. I'll come back in about half an hour. We'll see what happens. Guys, I've been hammering on this thing for at least 20 minutes anyway, maybe 25 minutes. I just can't get the heat I want. I want the taper up higher in the bell, but it's just not happening. So I'm going to go back to the rim itself. I'm going to put it over the horn. We'll try flaring it out. We'll go with a fake it and make it kind of approach and see what happens. Standing it straight up in the forge now, at least I can get the entire round heated up. And I'm just going to work it out like this, all the way around. But, you know, so I kind of wanted the flare to start out here and come back. I don't think we're going to get that far, but I'll keep heating this rim and moving it out, and we'll see what happens. I'm going to give this rim one more go here to see what we end up with. She's coming out a little better this way. If I can sneak in another inch or so, that would be, I think, good enough for me to get her rounded up. Hopefully we haven't messed up its ability to resonate by doing this and all the hammering, but hey, live and learn, right? Talk about it, because I have no idea, but I've seen it happen when I've had square tube stock down in the forge, that all of a sudden I get hoof, 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 little shots of exploding, igniting gases. out the other end of the tube. So this bell I have standing straight up on the forge right now. Can you see it? Yeah, there it is. All right, but it's not totally enclosed. Where I welded at the top, there's two or three holes where gases can escape. So I don't know, and some of you guys can comment if you do, but I would think that it's possible that if you didn't have the ability for that gas to escape, that it would, that could build up inside there and maybe even ignite in there. Probably not. There might not be enough oxygen in that case. But as soon as you flip it up or something, you might get a little cannon out the other end. I don't know, but think about something like that. Don't, you know, when you're working with an enclosed container, be as scared as I am about it. Back to work.
If we could squeeze another half inch out of this thing, that would be awesome. I think she's coming up a little bit. I really do. I think if we kept at that, we could make something out of it. One more time, and then we'll just go with that. Like I said, the priority on this project isn't extremely high. I think I've proven the point that to get up in there, you need some other type of setup, that's for sure, to get a really good flare on the thing. But we are flaring it, and it could happen. One more heat, and then we'll clean it up. I get a little more aggressive on this. Let's see if we can get more movement, because I really want it to move more. Oh, missed. So I'm using the 3-pounder now. Barely get in there. I think that helped, I really do. Whew. I don't think I'm gonna go much farther than that. It ain't the prettiest bell in the world, but again, I really wanted to come up to here, but I think it doesn't look like exactly like a cylinder tank anymore. So I'm gonna heat this thing up. We're gonna clean it up a little bit, get some of the uniformity back into it so it doesn't look quite so hammered. And we'll be done. One more, I think.
Told you it wouldn't be a quick one.
Let's go ahead and see if we can get a little more roll on this.
Doesn't look too bad. Sometimes the camera, it doesn't look bad at all, actually.
Get some of the high spots out of there. I don't know, but I bet you the more uniform we are, the better it'll resonate. But I think that's it. We're gonna call that out. It's not exactly what I had in mind, but I think it'll do the trick. I have no idea what kind of steel this tank is made out of. This bell would probably do better hardened, but I think we're not even going to go down that path. I think we'll take what we got and go with it. We'll let her cool down, and we'll see if she still rings. I think I'll hear that. All right, let me get her cooled down. The reason I was going to hang that bell and then give him a little clanger thing, gong kind of thing, and let him ring, you know, ring it that way. But I decided that I'll go ahead and hang a clanger inside the, I guess what it's called, I don't know, inside the bell on a chain, and they can pull the chain, ding, 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 ding. So on top of the bell, so here we have the bell right now, right? So we'll have a chain, and I'll have a clanger inside there with a rope hanging off, and on the top here, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a round ring, and I'll just weld that on. I'm not gonna do anything fancy. I've spent enough time on this project, so, geez, I don't know if that's long enough. Yeah, I think that'll be long enough. Something like this, this is probably 3/4, pretty heavy, but it'll look good on that bell. So if I can't, I might find a little piece that's longer, but the next thing we're gonna do, turn this into a disc of some shape, a round disc, not a sphere, but more rounded than that, and then a flattened sphere, and then make this ring. I want to spend a huge amount of time on this. We'll just get this flattened down, round it off. A couple of heats and that'll be done. Flatter with this. Trick right there. Go a little thinner than we want on account of the fact that, when we round it, stop now. It'll fatten back up a little bit. If I can get the tongs where I want them to be, thank you. Just gonna round these edges a little. Not too far. Finish it up. Close enough for me, it's just a bell, nobody's gonna be seeing it anyway. All right, one more time. Also, I can sit on my ass on the deck and have a way for people to tell me they're here. Just round this thing down a little bit more. Crazy. It's not bad at all. Just flatten it back out. For a blacksmith shop bell, I'll say. For a school? No. But I think that'll do it. A little hockey puck to Ricky right there. We'll let that cool. We'll get working on that ring. Gonna make short work of this ring, and no, I'm not gonna forge weld it because I don't really want to put any more time into it than I have. Just enough. So that we say we made a ring for it. So, I'll stop slipping out of there because I'm not ready for you yet. Doesn't look too shabby at all. Too bad, Tom. I like it, actually. Question is, do I like it egg-shaped like that? And I almost do, but I know I don't. So. I don't hate it, though. I don't hate it. Let me think about this a little bit. I decided I want it round dish anyway, so that's what we're gonna do. I don't mind, it isn't perfect, but kind of round. I'm gonna weld it just like that, and as long as it's uniform, I'm okay. I'm gonna hammer it up just a little bit to make it a little rough. I think we're okay with that. I think that's good enough for my purpose. But I still gotta make a bracket to hang the darn thing. That's thinking ahead. So that's gonna go up on top. So there we go, that part's done. Let me get the bracket in. Hang it up outside of the door. Makes sense. I have a spot, a post that I can come out there. I'm gonna do an 18 inch vertical and a 24 inch to where I'm gonna have the hook. I think I can just hook it. I don't think I have to do anything else to it. And then I need some support in here somehow. I might just do a simple curb support like that. The question is, what do I make this thing out of? It's gonna be pretty heavy. I don't want to use 3/4. But let me figure it out. We'll get one piece, 18 and 24 and 2 and 3 and 4, 28. We'll call it 18 and 28 for size, and then figure out what the hell we're gonna make it out of. Some of them. Do you ever have one of those, what the hell was I thinking days? Oh my gosh, this is a project that never ends. It keeps going. All right, I decided to go with the freaking 3/4 square. I can't think of anything else that would justify hanging that bell from. So I marked my 18 inches. That's my vertical and my horizontal. I cut it 30. I got to go ahead and forge a taper and a hook on this thing. I really would like to do something fancy with a twist in it. I don't know if I'll do that or not. I'll put some little bit of a loopy loop in there. It's probably all going to be welded, so don't even think about we're going to go crazy fancy here. But let's put the taper and the hook on. All I wanted was a bet. Damn. See how freaking quick we can do this. Don't need much of a taper, just a little one. Gone a little deeper on the heat. Now I'll take one more. Sons of guns. Alright, let's get this paper finished up. What I'm after. Little 4-pounder. I'm gonna put a bit of a bevel here. Because I'm not gonna put a curly Q on the end. So I want something different out there. I think that'll do the trick. Alright. Put the hook in. Let's go ahead and put this hook in. Make sure I do what I want here. So I'm gonna start back here, and I wanna drop it the wrong way. Something like that. And then we'll come back and drop it the right way. Nice if we're down a little bit. I think that'll be a trick for what I'm at. So it ain't pretty, but it's there. He's done. He's good. All right, what am I going to do next? Before I put my 90 in, I'm going to go ahead and pre-drill my mounting holes. I might actually flare out the bottom of this to a little fishtail just to give it some decoration, and then get that 90 bent. Okay, talk about a project that goes crazy. So all I want to do is I want to fishtail this in, so I'm kind of fullering and tapering at the same time. I don't know how to do a fishtail, but that's how I do it. That's how I'm doing it today anyway. Just to add a little more decoration to this piece. After all, it is outside my front door. So, keep it simple, but we gotta go a little bit farther. And simple. And I think that's enough. Let me go with a smaller cross piece for a little more detail. I think that's not bad at all. Out. Doesn't look too bad. It ain't perfect, but it ain't horrible either. A little wider out here. That does it. And we're straight. Alright, that's that one. Now, again, I don't want to go crazy, but I think it's just going to be boring to put the screws in there, so I'm going to see what I can do about putting a dimple and a flare in each one of those to dress it up. So, told you I didn't think this was gonna be a quick video. Step, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this flatter that I built. I need a step. Because I have a rounded edge on that other side, and I'm gonna center that on the hole, and with the good old half brass, we're just gonna make that look like we did something to it. This is a style or not, but it is today. I don't want to spend a lot of time at it, but I do want it to look like we did something. So that's that. Even more over there. Like I said, I don't know if that's some technique somebody uses somewhere, but I certainly did today. Soften that up a little. Keep everything kind of running straight if we can. I'm going to have to lose my flare to do that, but that's okay. I'm okay with that. Everything straight. Again, it might look like crap, but it also is supposed to look a little bit abused. Alright, two more. And I'll be back. I got the dimples in it. I wanted. I'm not sure I'm happy with it, but it certainly does, gives the look that I wanted. We got the back nice and straight. I'll go back and re-drill those holes so that they're clean. Normally you drift those out, but I'm not going to do that. That'll give me time to cool this down. Once it's cooled down, we'll come back, we'll put this 90 in. The holes re-drill, everything looks okay. I mean, again, that's what it is. I got myself a little dimple mark there. That's where I want my 90 to begin. So from here to here, I want the 90. I don't know. I have no intention to do a 90-degree corner there, just a curve, a turn. We'll see how it goes. If it wants to move, we'll help it a little bit. So we're going to heat. Again, I want to just heat that area as close to that area as possible. My fire is pretty darn big right now, but let's heat that up, put a bend on it. Alright, we've got a decent heat on this, and I got it isolated as well as I could with what I have. I don't know where my brush is. Where's my dimple? It's right there. So we're going to go just a little, shit, I can't get into the vise. Go a little higher, maybe it'll help. But we'll go there. Come on. That's where I'll find 5-inch jar would be handy. We'll go ahead and bring this thing down. A little bit off because I'm crooked in the vise, but you can almost see it. We'll go ahead and we'll try to put a square corner on this. What the hell? We spent 3 hours on the damn thing anyway. We're back in the heat. Get that corner squared off. We'll see what we can do.
I've never done one.
I've never done or attempted one of these 90 degree turns before. I've seen videos of it. It seems like a heck of a lot of work. Well, let's do it. There's upsetting in one direction, and then there's upsetting in the other direction until you make it all happen. So we'll give it a go. What do we got to lose, right? It's easier, I think, if you have square ends to work on, so you can upset against something. But let's see what we got. This is squared back off. Oh, jeez, I totally missed it. Take the tail off and put it in there. All right, so there's the start of it. We'll keep going. What the heck? It was supposed to be a simple little project. Make a bow, you dumbass. Die Hard fans are enjoying this one because it's a super long video. Alright, let's get some more upsetting down here. I gotta upset it this way. I guess I can do that. Do you mind the frame? No. So I'm just trying to upset back this way. It's looking pretty good, actually. Somebody doesn't know what the hell they're doing. We're getting close. We're getting close. Getting there. I think one more heat and Sam is going to felt pretty damn close. I still got quite a bit here to offset. We'll see what happens. One more go here at least. Let's see what we got going on. Still want to offset in this direction. Upset in this direction. I guess I can hold it against it. For the sake of the video, anyway, I'll hold it against it. So we're close. Almost close enough for me. Since we've gone this far, what we'll do now is one more heat. We'll actually go to the vise now. I know a lot of you guys have probably been yelling, go to the vise for a while. And see if we can get that outside corner a little bit more square. Holy mom. If we're successful, I can check one more new thing off my list. I really want it down here somewhere, but I don't want to freaking mark up my thing. It looks like it should be pretty dang close. Let's see, I want to go this way with it. Ooh, that's a little toasty. Toasty fried. Alright, we can go right in the corner now. both directions, because it is what it is. So we're going to copy, whether you agree or not. For a rookie like me, you see a little bit over there still. Right, let's get our behinds 90-ish. I mean bad right there. A bit more. Everything looks alright. Alright, the most important part is out here. We're close enough, I think. Clean this off a little. Hey, let's hang a bell up, Chandler. Good idea, Chandler. Alright.
Not bad for a freaking monkey with a hammer, huh? It ain't great, but it ain't bad at all. Alrighty. Now, the only thing we have left to do, besides put everything together, you can see. Because I wanted to put a bracket in here, but the problem is, you know, these are all the things you want to think of ahead of time. If I put a bracket in here, how am I going to put my screws in? Do you know what I mean? So I got to figure out what kind of bracketing I can put in and still have room to put the screws in. I'll be back. So there's the bracket on the layout tail. Here's one screw. Here's the other, or hole, and then there's the other one, all right? So let's say I need that much room to get at those things. So if I were to come out, let's say, with a curly Q here, and a curly Q there, or could I come out and do a curly Q there like that? Scroll, sorry, I call everything around there. So I think we can squeeze that in if we're tight enough. No, I want to go the other way. If we're tight enough, we can do that. Okay, I'm down with that. So, next thing is how much do we need? 3 inches there, and 5 and 6 and 24, and okay, so I cut a piece already that's 36 inches long. I think we can make that happen. I think, actually, I don't need quite so much. I'm about 2 inches too long, I would say, with that 33 inch piece. Of course, I could just go like that, and that would work too. Do I need the scroll, or can I just go ahead and put her in like that and be done with it? I'm kind of not hating that. Oh, let's see. Done is done, right? Done is done in more cases than not. Now, I'm going to shut you off because you're wasting time. Since we went this far, that I'm going to go ahead and put the scroll work in. And I need, like I said, I think I was just a couple inches too long on my initial guess. I think somewhere in that range. We'll cut that off and make the scroll. We got a little fishtail action going on already. You know, I should have rounded this. I'm just going to fishtail this a little. I think that's enough. And then we want that fishtail to be on the inside, so then we'll start our scroll here. Let me go in for a little more heat. We'll put our little scroll on the end. Go ahead, this will be a nice tight turn here, and then we'll just finish it off. This is really a pretty tight scroll. It's too tight. That's a little too tight, I think. Alright guys, I'm going to do something I've never done before. I'm going to cut out the next 10 minutes of footage that I have here. It's on that scroll. This scroll fought me the entire way, and I looked it over twice. There's absolutely nothing educational or entertaining about this footage, so I'm going to pull it out of there. As you can tell, today was an off day anyway. Nothing. I mean, I was saying the wrong things, and things were just going crazy. So I apologize for the censorship in this video. But you can probably thank me, because I just saved 10 minutes of your life. Now let's get back to the all I wanted was a bell video. Yes.
because I'm a little short on my scroll. But I think something like that's all I need. Just a little brace kind of scroll. Let's see how it fits. By this very per design, but pretty darn close enough to me. I think we can get into all three of those now. Another question is, since Chandler made this such a big project anyway, what are we going to use to attach these? Should he rivet them? Should he weld them? And I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I'm just going to weld the son of a bitch up and be done with it, because I need to get on to other things. I already spent like 3 hours on this project. We still got the whole bell to put together. So I'm just going to weld those guys in place, just to remind Chandler that he ain't where he wants to be yet. All right? So we're close. I mean, we got some cool attributes on there. So let me go ahead. We got the ring and all of that to put on the bell still. So that ring will go on there like that. I think that'll look cool and beefy. And we'll hang this thing up inside. We'll hang this thing up inside here. There's my little knocker. Hopefully that'll work. Get things all put together and I will come back when it's done. Holy cow, what did I get into? All right, we got her all mocked up. I think we're good to go. I'm gonna clear coat the bell. I'm gonna leave the bracket to rust. That's what I want it to do. But I think it looks good. I wish I had done something different than welding, but that's the way it is. I think that does the trick. It's a hell of a lot of work just to ring a bell. But if somebody shows up at the shop and you don't see me, ring the bell and we'll go. All right, let me get her hung up all the way. You dumbass. All right, well, you saw it. I just wanted a bell outside. If I'm out back on the deck or in the back room or in the wood shop and somebody comes here, I don't know that they're here. So you can see the bell up there in the corner. She looks pretty hanging there. The bracket comes out long enough so that the door, when I have the main door open, it's not locking the bell. Chandler's not here. Do you want to find him? That was 1,000 times more work than I thought. But we did a lot of different things, right? We learned that you couldn't flare that stuff with the technique that I used. We learned that that tank sounds really cool. And we learned, well, I did our first right angle, 90 degree turn, whatever you call it, on a 3/4 round or square. So that's it. Hope you enjoyed it, because, I mean, at least hope you had some popcorn or beer or something to watch this long ass video. But we saw a lot of work. It was almost like you spending the day with me. So till next time, take it easy.